DC fandom has made us wait way, way too long for this trailer. I understand it's the last trailer that they've shown, and they always save the best for last. But oh my gosh, it's been hours! I've been sat here waiting for this trailer for hours, and it's finally here, and it's ready to go. So, I've watched the behind the scenes. It was good. It was dark. It was gritty. It felt very, very, very much like Batman. The more I see the suit, the more I like it. I just haven't seen the trailer yet, and as soon as I click play, it's gonna start. And I don't know why I'm making myself wait any longer. It's because I wanted to record my reaction because the behind the scenes, oh, it was good. If you haven't seen it, go and see it. Also, the cast, when they were talking to each other, seemed really, really friendly. They seemed like they had like a lot of charisma, that they had a lot of chemistry with each other. It was good so far. I'm just the whole moment I've been waiting for is the trailer, and I'm just really, really excited. And I know I watched the first trailer last year. That was really good. I just hope that this trailer is gonna be just as good or better, and I hope that the film is gonna live up to the trailers. So here we go. I'm just excited. Oh, I can feel my heart pounding. So dark and gritty. It's the Riddler. I was holding my breath. I was wondering what they were building up to.
Fear is a tool. But when that light hits the sky, it's not just a call. It's a warning.
The more I see him, the more I like it. I do. Oh, look how high-tech his suit is. He has so many gadgets. I'm okay with this.
I've been trying to reach you. Fire the gun! Powder King and Riddler's to match.
Catwoman.
I can take care of myself.
Yes!
If this continues, it won't be long before you've nothing left.
I have words about Catwoman.
It's only gonna get worse for you.
Oh my god! Oh,
take it easy, sweetheart.
Penguin sounds good.
Ancient.
Okay, so when I think about comic book Catwoman,
who are you under there?
She is like perfect for it, in my opinion.
I'm vengeance.
Oh, that was smooth. Oh, damn. I really like it. So much going on. Oh man, there's so much to talk about. Honestly, I don't want to miss dialogue. I'm frightened to talk, but I'm already talking. It makes no sense. I have so much to say. Is that it? I think that's it. I know what I'm doing next year, March. I know what I'm doing. Right, okay. So, oh God. Okay, so the last time I watched the Batman trailer was a year ago for the last DC fandom, and I wasn't sure if Pattinson would do a good job. Judging from the first trailer, I said yes, I think he would, but I don't really know where I stood. Since then, I've watched more of his films. I've watched The Lighthouse. I think he's a really good actor, because a lot of people were like, oh no, you need to watch some of his other films. If you haven't seen much of him, you're missing out. I watched it. I think he's a great actor. I can see where he's going with this Batman, and I think he's really, really embodying Year One Batman. Now, what I mean by that is Year One Batman hasn't quite come to the realization of who he is as a person yet, and he's young and he's brooding and he's got up all this pent-up rage and emotions that he just wants to take out on people. And I think that Pattinson plays this very well. The next person I want to talk about, like, this is all just in my brain, I wanted to say all of it while it was showing, but I didn't want to miss anything, is Catwoman. Oh my god, like, when I think of Catwoman in the comics, I think of like quite sleek but very like her eyes say everything. I think of her as like very, very expressive as a person, but not with her words, but more with like how she looks at people. She's got these wide puppy dog eyes. I know that sounds really stupid, saying Catwoman with puppy dog eyes, but I think she embodies it perfectly. And I haven't seen her act in anything, but from the glimpses I've seen there, this way she looks at Batman, it looks like she's like lusting over him, but also the way she looked at him when he was beating up those people. Oh, it was like, you could see the cogs in her mind. Even though she didn't say anything, it was the cogs in her mind you could see through her eyes. I don't know if that made any sense. In my mind, it does. Where you could see if she was like, damn, do I stay? Do I run? What do I do next? I don't know what to do. She seems as if she's coming into her own as a character as well. I know that Catwoman's an established character. Batman's an established character. All the characters, Riddler, Penguin, they're all established characters. But this is going back to year one of Batman. And I like the fact that she's not completely like, oh, well, let me just steal this. Oh, you like me, eh? She's not completely flirty. She is very flirty, very true to the comics. But you can also see in her face, she's like, oh, what am I getting myself into? And I like that. I like that she is almost there, but not quite there as Catwoman. I love that so much. I don't know if I explained that correctly, but in my mind it made sense. Penguin. I don't really know what to think of Penguin. Haven't seen him enough. Like, the Catwoman's expressions was enough for me for that trailer. Penguin, I quite liked his voice. I know that people will disagree with me, but I think that his voice pretty much suits Penguin. Like, when I think of Penguin, that's the sort of voice I hear. But I don't know, I haven't seen enough to judge him. I don't know if that makes any sense, but I haven't seen enough of Penguin in that trailer to judge him and be like, oh yeah, no, he makes a fantastic Penguin. I think the Catwoman makes a fantastic Catwoman. I think that Robert Pattinson, I think he does a great job. I think he's going to make a good Batman. I haven't seen enough of Penguin. Riddler, he makes me really curious. I don't think we've seen his face like properly full on. I like the fact that they're holding back off that. I really, really like the fact that we keep seeing him from behind or with a mask on. And I'm very excited to see where this goes. And I like the fact that they've given us tiny, tiny little clues. I didn't have a chance to read them all on the screen, but I want to know what's at stake. Is it people? Is it money? Is it like, I don't know. What is at stake? Is it the loyalties? I don't know. It's got me so curious. And it's like, usually they spoil everything in a trailer. I don't feel like anything was spoiled. Yes, they showed a lot of fighting. Yes, they showed some of the hints, but we don't really know what's going on. We can understand from seeing Penguin, Catwoman, Riddler, they're bad guys, but I don't think they're established bad guys yet. Maybe Riddler is, but he is still coming into his own. He seems like a really, really brainy person, but I don't think he's quite the villainous Riddler that we know these days. I don't know. Again, I don't know if that made any sense. In my head, it does. I'm just very excited to see where they go with this, and I really want to know what's at stake, but I don't want spoilers. Either way, I want to know what you guys think of this trailer. Personally, I loved it. I liked all the actors. I want to see more of Officer Gordon. I want to know if there are any other villains they're going to sneak in quietly. But I don't want to spoil too many things, but I want to know. So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll catch you next time. Bye, guys.